Hello, coders. First of all, I want to thank you for more than 100 subscribers. This actually motivates me to create more videos. If you are new to this retro channel, subscribe for more amazing videos like this one. And that way we can make this channel as big as possible. Anyway, let's get started. Last time, we were able to post data to our Firebase project using post request using Axios. So if you are interested in knowing about how posting data to Firebase in React, you can check out this video. I'll also pin it on the screen top right corner so that you can easily access it. So I made some changes to our app. As you can see, there is a name, unit, and grid on the screen. And let's take some a little tour to our app so that we can see the changes. The instance.js is where we created our instance, Axios instance. I renamed this from results.js to instance.js because I realized that results, I'm using the word results a lot in our app, so it might create some confusion. So make sure you add this, or if you don't have this file, make sure you add it, instance.js. And then this base URL is our URL here at our database. This URL, it is the base URL, if you remember, it is what we have here. Another thing is that I created two new components, the results fetch.js. It is a class-based component because we are going to handle state in this component. So I have also hooked up a results display component here. And this is where you can see the name, unit, and grid. This is a functional component. We are not going to handle state here. We are just using this component to display our record, because fetching data is not the same as displaying the data on our app. So I also hooked our results fetch.js to our results to our app.js. So in our app.js we have results add and results fetch, so that we can actually display this data to the screen. So results add is where we had a form to input data, and we used some logic to post our data to the backend. If you are okay with this one, you don't have to look at it. But if you are not okay, reference the video that I have told you to, so that you can understand what is happening here. So let's continue. I'll go to results fetch.js. Here we are going to handle the state. So use state. I'm going to set state here. State is equals. And the only thing that we have at our state is results. And then I'll place it as an empty array that way. And then because we are loading data from the backend, we are going to use the component digmount function, component digmount. And then this is where we are going to use our instance. So make sure to import instance from the location that your file is. So mine is at APIs folder, and then instance.js. So if you don't have this file, make sure you create it and paste the URL of your database here so that we can use this instance in our application. So instance.get in bracket results.json. Now this results is the one that we have in our Firebase, this name results here. Okay, this one results here. So results dot json. Remember to put the dot json, otherwise it won't work. And then we can handle the dot then here, so that we can handle the response. Is a callback function. Let's first console.log response. We console.log our data, and let's see what we have here. So save this file, and our app will refresh. Let's inspect the element console, and you can see that we are already receiving our object, and our object has a key and the record. This is the exact record that we have from our Firebase. So we are already actually fetching the data. Now, how can we display this data in on our screen? Because we are receiving an object, we have to convert this object into an array. So this is what we are going to do. We are going to convert our object into an array, and then we are going to group the array using the dot map method, so that we can display the records on the screen using props. Okay, so let's do this. To convert the object into an array, I'm going to use a for in brackets let key. Remember, this key is the auto-generated key here that we are receiving here. So let key in response dot data curly braces. So we are going to create a helper method. So on top of for, I'm going to use a const fetched results. So you can name this any name that you want. So results. Fetch results is equals to an empty array, and then we close that one. So we can now use this fetch results in our for. So fetch results dot push. So this dot push will add a new, each new record will be added at the end of an array. So as you can see, the fetch results is an empty array. Each new record will be added at the end of an array. If you want to it to be added in front of the array, you can use the unshift method. Okay, this will also work. This will add in front of the array, and then the push will add at the end of the array. So we are going to use the spread operator to create the new array. So use the spread operator, then response new object response dot data, and then remember we have a key, so press this key there. And then comma, because we don't want to lose this key, we will store it as an ID. So I'll say ID as key that way. The next thing is we want to set to update our state using the fetch results. Now this fetch results holds an array of records from response data. And since we have converted this into an array, we want now to set it to be our results. So below this, I will set state here, this dot set state. So results, we are setting the results as our fetched results. So I'm copy-pasting this one to be our fetched results there. And this way we are actually updating our results, fetching the results in form of an object, setting it into, converting it into an array, and then setting the array into these results as we are using this dot set state. Now we want to display our fetch data into our into our app or on the screen. So I'm first going to remove this one because I want us to map through the array. So this dot state dot results dot map. So we are mapping over the results, and then now we handle a single instance of the results. So let's call it a result. Not this is results, and then this is result, but you can use any other name here. This is just a folder that will help us to access each record. So it's a callback function. Then now we can use our results display here. So remember to import result display into this file. So result display, and then in results display is where we have a we are using the props. So let's add the props here. The first prop is the key. The key is equals to result dot id or whatever name you use here, dot id. Okay, and then we also want to handle the name will be equal to result dot name, and then the grade will be equal to the unit first unit result dot unit, and then the grade will be equal to result dot grade. Now we can use save that file. We can use this props in results display. So make sure you add props here, props, and then at unit we are accessing props dot name. Now this name is it is what we have used here, this name, and it is also what we have in our Firebase, this name. Okay, so props dot. props.name. Remember to place them in these brackets because this is JSX. And then I'm going to copy paste this one to this one and this one. Then make sure to change name to unit and grade to grade. Save this file. Let's see if this one works. Refreshing. Yes, it have actually worked. We are actually getting our data. As you can see, name is Chao Codes. Unit is React. Grade is Sunny. This is the data that we have here. And it is the data that we also used the console.log to display here. So let's add another data. We see if this works, Charles. And then the unit, let's say name, node, let's say node. The grid, let's say it's an A. We submit, wait for response. We have received the response. Our data have been posted. So let's refresh this one. And you can see we have our response again. We have this record, and then it was also added here, the node and charts, and it is now displayed on the screen. And you can see it is displayed the first one because we used unshift. So if we change the unshift to push, we change this to push and save this one, the you can see React now is displayed first. Initially Node was displayed first. That's pretty much it, guys. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe now. I'll be creating more videos on web development and programming, and thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.